This is a cockatoo taking the tram. The clever bird named Cookie was taking a ride from Sydney Central Station to the casino on a Sunday night. And he even brought a ticket. On TikTok, the video went viral. But Cookie is just the tip of Sydney's feathered social media iceberg. Amidst the cityscape, hundreds of sulfur-crested cockatoos weave through the Aussies' daily lives, some casually snacking, others exploring apartment living. The cockatoos are always up for surprises and for selfies. But how did these majestic birds become social media stars? Why do some of them have yellow tags? And what lured them to the big city anyway? Well, here in the heart of Sydney, the sulfur-crested cockatoos aren't just surviving, they're thriving. These adaptable creatures have seamlessly integrated into the urban narrative, perching on skyscrapers, frolicking in parks, and even joining outdoor coffee breaks. What makes them truly fascinating is their ability to navigate the concrete jungle. With their sharply curved gray beaks and talons, snow-white feathers and yellow crest, they are one of Australia's most distinctive birds, and one of the most destructive ones. They have been known to open the lids of bins. They're notorious for destroying wooden things. They lop off the tops of flowers and hollow out trees. In short, they love to make a big old mess. It's not a surprise that they are annually nominated in the vote for Australia's naughtiest bird. Despite the chaos, the people of Sydney adore them, and they love to grab a photo with the cocky, as they call the cockatoos. Today, it's impossible to imagine the city without these magnificent birds, but that wasn't always the case. Centuries ago, there were no recorded sightings of sulfur-crested cockatoos anywhere near downtown Sydney. The species was only present around the city fringes, but during the last decades, more and more of the birds have started flocking in from out of town. Why? Well, the birds love the big city because of its numerous dinner opportunities. Sydney is full of food. And sulfur-crested cockatoos are generalists. They'll eat all sorts, even leftovers. And they've learned how to get them. The cockatoos are copying their human neighbors. They are capable of mimicking human actions, like going upside down or opening trash bins. A unique citizen science project allows people to report the birds' daily activities. The Wingtag project is turning Sydney residents into real cockatoo trackers. The project allows people to learn about the birds' personalities, ages, partners, and favorite spots. It's like playing Pokemon Go, but with real-life birds and meaningful scientific impact. The project started with 70 cockatoos from Sydney's Royal Botanical Gardens, which have been fitted with harmless plastic wing tags. Each tag has its own number. The tags are easily visible, so people can spot them. When people began to notice tagged birds, they were quick to find out what was going on. The Wingtag project became an instant hit and the world's first social parrot network. Today, it's such a success that it's evolved into an app named Big City Birds. This app lets people directly photograph a bird and instantly report the whereabouts of any individual. Be it breakfast at Bondi Beach or dinner on a private balcony, the birds are everywhere. Some pigeons might be jealous about these special guest list dinner opportunities, or maybe also about the cockatoo's cool nicknames. Because to Sydney's residents, they are way more than just a number. So, there we have Brain, Shadow, Watermelon, and Lizzie, who prefers to bring friends along. Each bird has its own personality. Some cockatoos have become experts in posing for photos. Others have become experts in letting themselves into their favorite apartment. No matter what they're up to, one thing is certain. Watching sulfur-crested cockatoos is an ever-entertaining saga. and humans love to share their bird encounters. By using social media, the project is a unique way to engage the public in scientific research. The Big City Birds findings will help work out how we can share urban areas with wildlife. Something very important in a world increasingly dominated by people. Cockatoos are not the only ones who have chosen a big city life. Check out our playlist and get to know many more Wild City Trawlers.